person. So you will be sure that he is safe, okay? This is what I told you about the knees. When you have to crawl, this is what you put on your knees. This is the mask, this is the headlight, the helmet, and the gloves. And this is the uniform we use for earthquakes. It is very hot, but it is fireproof, and it is so big that it is not able to scratch easily, okay? So you can crawl more easily. It is very hot, but it makes your body feel safe. This one is for the spine. Like that one we have for the head, this one is for the spine. It's a small one, but it keeps the spine straight. It is not moving around. Those are the gloves, the glasses I told you about the dust. This isn't an earthquake. This is a picture from the whole team. We took part in a training 2 years before in Volos, one other city, and we were from Hellenic Rescue Team, from many bunches of Hellenic Rescue Team from different cities. So we did a very, very big training, and this is the final photo. It was a three days training course. This is part of the course. This is part of the course as well. As I told you, the drill team with this equipment made the hole, and then the first aid team goes inside. And here it is for the head as well. It is more steady. This is the way you put one victim inside. You have to... I cannot demonstrate it here, but you can see in the photo. One is holding the hand steady. One is holding the legs. And the other one is holding like that, so he will not be able to move the hands. And one is holding from here. It is better if you don't hold from clothes. It is better if you can hold from the body. Okay? And with a 1, 2, 3, and in 3, you take him up. 1, 2, 3, with 3, you put him inside here. Okay? So you will reduce the movement. If you can control how you will pull him up and how you will pull him down, you reduce the movement of the body without reason. Okay, so those are the photos. Before starting with the PowerPoint presentation, which is about first aid, I just want to ask you if you have any questions about how we react, etc. Can you please repeat the question? How will you help? I can. Who? Okay. This is what we are doing in disaster management, okay? Now I will tell you about some things for first aid, okay? About burnings, about fractures, about hypothermia, etc. So those are things that you have to know even for your personal life, okay? Even if you're not in the health field, it is good to know for your personal life. And as I told before, here we created a disaster management course. CARE created a disaster management course with my help. So it will be a disaster management course based on what we do in Greece. It will not be so big, and we will not be able to use all the drill equipment and all that, because in India it is not so easy. The government is not cooperating so much, so we cannot get that equipment for free. But it will be a full first aid and knowing how to react when a disaster happens, okay? It will be 2.5 months course, so if you want, you can participate on this course. This is just an introduction about some subjects that will be on the course, and one introduction about English, so you will understand the whole point. When it will take place in India? This course, in Greece, in my country. In India, it will take place in February, maybe, if we have the... No. We have the schedule. You were not here before, I think. And we are waiting for the submission of the municipality. After the submission of the municipality, we will hire all the experts, doctors, firefighters, policemen, psychologists, all the experts who need to be part of a good disaster management course. And after that, we will decide the place. Okay? The police will give us some place. The firefighters will give us a place. For each topic, we will have a different place. Okay? So, for using the fire extinguishers, we will have a place provided by the firefighters. For crowd management, we will have a place provided by police. So, it will not be a certain place. The places will be changed. Okay? We didn't decide it yet. Because it depends on how much the people, the experts, will ask from us. It depends on how much the firefighters, the doctors, and all that would want. In Greece, I'm talking about, at that time, I'm talking about Greece, okay? And as I told here, we will not be able in India to do the same thing with heavy equipment. You will not be able to use heavy equipment because you don't have this heavy equipment, and even if you have, you have to pay a lot of money to rent it. And when a disaster happens, you cannot just take the equipment of the police or the firefighters and you use it. It is not how it's working here. So you will be, after this course, the participants will be support team for the government. It will be support team. They will not be in front. They will don't take the machines and start drilling. They will provide food. They will provide water. They will provide first aid. They will provide knowledge, but they will not take the equipment and start working. Okay? It is different how we work in Greece and how you will work here. You will practice it in the disaster management course.
After the course, when will we practice it? Because then we will be providing for the government water, toilets, and food.
You will not provide. You know, in the disaster management course, you will be taught how to settle down a fire, first aid, and all that, okay? And when a disaster happens, the government will call you. And if you want, you will be able to go and help by providing them food, water, and all that, whatever they need. Okay? But it will be part of your practice, of those 2.5 months practice. So after that, after exams, you will have a certificate that I practice in this subject, and this subject. So now I feel comfortable to help when a disaster happens in those 3-4 subjects. I don't feel comfortable to do something else. I'm not trained to do something else. I'm trained on those points, so I will help only on those points. Yes, and generally it is your choice what you will do. A rescuer, if he doesn't feel good with something, or he feels that something is very dangerous, or he feels that hungry, even if you feel hungry and you are a rescuer, and your headmaster, no, and the boss, let's say, okay, the chief of the rescue team tells you, go inside and take this victim out, but you feel hungry, you can tell, I'm not going. Because I'm feeling hungry, and I think that it is dangerous for me, that I will feel dizzy and I will faint. Or my leg is paining, or my head is paining, or I feel very stressed because I think that someone is dead there, and I don't want to face any dead people. So it is up to you. Nothing is compulsory. If you don't feel good, you don't help. You can help by providing water. Someone else is working, and your help is to provide water and food to him. It is volunteerism as well. It is help, and it is very important help. Or to build up a toilet, or to build up